بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وبعد السلام عليكم and welcome back to Quranic Connection TV. I'm Abdul Shaheed and in today's episode I want to talk to you about a very important subject, the subject of repentance or tawbah. This episode was inspired by a question one of you asked me, and the question was, does Allah miss a slave if they were once very pious but they stopped praying? And that's such an important question, because within it we have so many beneficial lessons. Inshallah, we'll discuss very quickly in this episode anyway. Does Allah love the servant? You know, does Allah love his servant even if they are sinners? And that's a very important question. Secondly, what do we do when we have turned away from the obedience of Allah, when we've fallen into sin, maybe we've been continuous in sin? What do we do when this happens to us? And thirdly, is there a way to rectify this situation without further exacerbating it or dragging it out? You know, what's the quickest way to solve this problem? And to answer this, I want to give you I want to talk to you about a couple of verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran. But before we get into this, like, first of all, like, you know, tawbah or repentance, istighfar, like repenting to Allah, turning back to Allah, like, this is actually a foundational state of a believer. You see, every one of us, regardless of who it is, like, we are always in need of turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking for forgiveness. You see, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's the best of humanity. He was someone who didn't sin. Allah protected him from that. But even though Allah protected him from that, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew how beloved this was. He knew how this was the key to happiness. And so he sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's narrated in some narrations that he would make istighfar, like, ask for forgiveness from Allah more than 70 times a day. In other narrations, it's more than 100 times a day. So what about you and I? You know, what about us when we are constantly falling into these, you know, acts that are acts of disobedience, these things that Allah is not happy with? And, you know, how often, ask yourself the question. I mean, I ask myself this very same question. Do I make repentance, like, sincerely repent to Allah, like, you know, maybe 15, 20 times a day? Do I do that? What about 10 times a day? Do I repent to Allah 10 times a day? How about 5 times a day? Ask yourself, are you repenting to Allah? Are you asking Allah for forgiveness even 5 times a day? Because the messenger of Allah, the best of humanity, the one who did not sin, he asked Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to forgive him more than 70 times a day, right? So if that's the case, then it's absolutely imperative for the likes of you and I that we nurture this habit, because it should become a habit. It should be habitual that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for forgiveness. Now, it is the verse of the Quran that I want to mention to you, because, like, first of all, like, the questioner asked the question, like, you know, does Allah miss the slave that was once pious? Does Allah miss the slave that was once pious? Meaning, you know, like, who doesn't fluctuate in their iman? Who isn't strong at one point in their life and become weak at another? And obviously there are different reasons for why we become weak, but main one being sin. But who doesn't? Like, we all fall into that situation of weakness. Like, we go through ups and downs in our level of iman, in our strength of faith. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us categorically, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَحِّرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us this. Like, you know, there is no one, like, this is from Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about actual marital relationships, right? Allah is talking about marital relationships because, look, let's be honest, like so many people today fall into sin, and the sin that they're falling into is al-fawahish, zina maybe, or maybe it's not even zina, maybe it's within the marriage itself. وَعِيَّذُ بِاللَّهِ. But the thing is, like we fall into a state of sin. Now, in this verse here, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. Indeed, Allah loves the one who repents. Allah loves the one who makes tawbah. وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَحِّرِينَ. And loves the one that purifies themselves. And so the thing is, like, you know, from a technical perspective, if you think about this verse, like when you're making tawbah, when you're asking Allah for forgiveness, you are actually purifying yourself also. How are you purifying yourself? You're purifying yourself. It's a spiritual purification where you're ridding yourself of the sin that you've committed by making istighfar. Now, a physical act of spiritual purification is wudu. When we make wudu, like when we make the ablution before the salah, like cleansing yourself, it's a spiritual cleanse. Although we do it physically, it's a spiritual cleanse. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us that, you know, Allah wipes away the sins when you make ablution, when you make wudu. And so in this verse specifically, you know, this is from Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the relationship between the husband and the wife. And here, obviously, Allah, the one who falls into error, and falls into error when the wife is on the time of the month, and because of that strong desire that all humans have, they fall into error. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا تَطَحَّرْنَا فَأْتُوهُنَّ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَمَرَكُمُ اللَّهِ. Like if she purifies herself, meaning cleanses herself, then approach her. But then in this verse, obviously this is talking about sexual relationships. But in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in this case where this is under the banner of marriage, like people still, you know, transgress the bounds, because we're human. Allah knows that we're human. Allah knows, and you know, may Allah protect us from our weakness. Our weakness is caused by our desires, but Allah knows that we can fall into this. And so, what does Allah say? Allah tells you that Allah loves you. Allah tells you how. Allah says, "Inna Allah yuhibbu tawabin." Allah loves the one who makes tawbah. Loves the one who makes tawbah. وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَحِّرِينَ, and loves the one who purifies themselves. And you and I, we should be really focused on purifying ourselves by making the spiritual tawbah, like, you know, physically repenting, like asking for forgiveness. And ultimately, you know, this is, you know, I mentioned this verse because here Allah is telling you that, you know, you fall in, you know, this falling into a sin, you know, under the banner of marriage, or, you know, even outside of marriage, people, you know, in today's society, we find that so many Muslims are falling into a state of zina. Like, it begins with zina of the eyes, where you know, they're unmarried, they're looking at each other, and before long, you know, the shaitan, he waters those desires, he makes you think about it, and you think about it, and what happens is that desire becomes stronger and stronger. And when the desire becomes stronger, eventually people fall into a state of zina, or a state of sin. And you know, the least, you know, whether it's the zina of the eyes, and I talk specifically about zina because this is something prevalent in our times. This is something prevalent in our society. It's the norm, in fact, in our society that people have in relationships outside of marriage. Marriage is becoming, you know, a thing of the past. Of course, within Islam, that's not the case. For the Muslims, like, marriage is the foundation of the family unit, and in fact, marriage is the foundation of society. And so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in addressing this such a serious issue, Allah tells us that even when you make those mistakes, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. Indeed, Allah loves those who turn back to Him in tawbah, like they are turning back in repentance. They are turning back in you know, they're feeling the pain of having disobeyed Allah. They're feeling the pain, the shame, because that's what happens, right? Like when we fall into sin, we feel the shame of falling into that sin, and we don't want to stand before Allah. Now, it may not be this question, you know, I'm given an extreme example. It may not be an issue of zina. It could just be an issue of sin. You know, many of us commit sins. We belittle them. We make them so small that it's no big deal. And those sins, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, they're like a black spot that appears on the heart. And it continues to appear until the heart becomes darkened. The darker the heart becomes, the more it deflects the light of guidance, meaning the guidance will not enter it. And if the guidance does not enter your heart, then you won't act upon it. And that's really important, because when we stop acting upon the guidance of Allah, on the Quran and the Sunnah, even if you know it and you stop acting upon it, it's usually because of those sins. And so we commit sin where, you know, we're backbiting, we're talking about others, we're taking other people's rights, we're dealing in the disobedience of Allah in whatever form it comes in. And when that happens, like what happens, we become more distant, we become shy to stand before Allah in prayer, because we know the sins that we're committing. And because we're not stopping, it's like, how can you stand in salah before Allah and you know that you've just committed sins? You see, the thing is, Allah is telling you that He loves those who make tawbah, and Allah is showing you a way out. And it's not just that Allah loves you to make tawbah, but Allah is telling us in Surah Az-Zumar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says regarding you and I, the one who's feeling, you know, despair now, we're feeling despair, you know, we feel like Allah will not be merciful to us. Why? Because of the sins that we've committed. We know what we've done, and as a result of that, we start to feel desperate. We start to feel like we're so far away from the Creator. And you believe in the Creator, you believe in the one who sustains your life, you know, because your life is full of blessings, right? So you believe, and so as a result of that, we feel that despair. And it's the barrier between us and Allah is our sins. But look what Allah says. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Oh my servant. Allah, you know this, when Allah says, يَا عِبَادِي. عِبَادِي, being an Arabic, I'm just going to throw a bit of Arabic into this, because I'm an Arabic teacher. The Arabic here is, عِبَاد is the servants, right? But when Allah says, my servants, this is the ya and nasab. The ya and nasab here is the ya of making it mine. Allah is making you His servant. Allah is attaching you to Himself. Like, look at this. This is sharaf. This is takrim. This is honor. Allah honors you by calling you His servant. Allah doesn't call you a slave or a servant. Allah says you are His servant. So, you know, when we want to show our love and appreciation to our children, for example, we say, oh, my son, my daughter, like my beloved, right? When you attach them to yourselves, it makes them, it gives them that feeling of belonging, that you belong to Allah, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, oh, my servant who has wronged themselves. They transgressed against themselves. Like, you didn't transgress against Allah. You couldn't take anything from Allah. So Allah says, you've wronged yourself. And then what does Allah say? Allah says, La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Don't despair. Don't fall into this despair. Don't fall into this feeling that there is no, you know, the mercy of Allah won't come to you, because Allah will. Allah says then immediately after, Inna Allaha yaghfiru dhunuba jami'an. Indeed, Allah forgives all sins. Can you imagine that? You haven't prayed, Allah will forgive you for that sin. Turn back to Allah and repent, Allah will forgive it. You haven't given your zakat for years. Give your zakat, turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance, Allah will forgive you. You haven't prayed. Like, this is the purpose of your existence, but you haven't prayed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, turn back to Allah. Allah will forgive all sins. There is no sins that you look. Inna shirka la dhulmun adhim, the greatest sin, which is to commit shirk, to associate partners of Allah, to worship other than Allah. And Allah says that even shirk, Allah will forgive you if you turn back in repentance, if you abandon it. So, you know, this is such an important question, because Allah is telling us that He loves us even more so because we turn back and ask for forgiveness. When you turn back and ask for forgiveness, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recognizes that you are His slave. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't despair. Don't despair from the mercy of Allah, because the mercy of Allah is infinite. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'an. Indeed, Allah will forgive all sins. Innahu huwa al-ghafur rahim. Indeed, He is the perpetual forgiver. He never stops forgiving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never stops forgiving. So if you have fallen into this situation where you haven't prayed for a while, then my suggestion to you is, number one, turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make istighfar, repent to Allah. The very first thing, if you're not praying and you haven't been praying and you're listening to this right now, right? If you're listening to this right now and you're thinking, yeah, I haven't prayed for years. I haven't, I don't pray, right? Or maybe I pray occasionally. If you're listening to this, it's not because you want to listen to me. You're listening to this because you are looking for a way back to Allah. You're listening to Islamic talks or Islamic videos or watching Islamic videos because you're looking for a way back to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the one that turns back to Him, Azza wa Jal. Allah loves that one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says immediately in the verse following this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa anibu ila rabbikum, and return to your Lord. You know, anaba yunibu, this isn't just to mean return. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have said, irji'u. The word raja'a, it means to return. Or ada ya'udu, to return. But Allah doesn't use that. Allah uses the word anaba yunibu. Anaba, it literally means someone who is constantly returning. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that we need to constantly return back to Him and submit. Wa aslimu lahu. Aslimu lahu, turn back to Allah and submit to Him. That's what Allah tells us. If you're constantly falling into sin, what does Allah say? قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Oh, my slave who is constantly wronging themselves, don't despair. Allah will forgive all sins. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. Turn back to Allah, constantly, because that's the state of our affairs. We are constantly falling into a situation where we are not doing the things that we should be doing. And when that happens, what does Allah say? The door of mercy is open. Turn back to Allah. Allah forgives all sins. Turn back. Don't waste a second. You see, the shaitan will come to you and make you feel as though, there's no saving you. You know, you've done too much. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you that the door of mercy is always open. Allah is the most merciful. He's the perpetual forgiver. He never stops forgiving. So if you are consistently returning to your Lord, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fix your affairs. Return to your Lord. So what's my advice? If you're not praying, what should you do? What's the number one thing that you should do? Right now, stop listening right now. Don't waste a second. Don't even think about this for a second. Go make wudu. Make wudu, make ablution. And, if it's time for salah, pray your salah. Don't think about it, because the shaitan will come to you and make you feel as though it's not worth it. You've spent all your life not doing it. Why go back now? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for you. Allah is waiting for you to return to Him. Allah says, لا تقنطوا, don't despair of my mercy. Don't despair of my mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you directly. And Allah says to you, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. Indeed, He loves those people who turn back in repentance. So stop right now. You don't need to listen to the end of this. You just need to go make wudu, stand in salah and pray two rakah. Pray two rakah, like do a voluntary prayer. Pray two rakah, make istighfar when you are in sujood. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. Because if you are in a state of remorse and you're really regretting like how you've been living. Sorry, just a second. Even I talk too much. So when you are in a state of remorse and you're really feeling it, then at that stage, you need to be turning to Allah. Make istighfar at that time. Repent to Allah at that time. How do you make repentance? Like pray two rak'at, nafal, like supererogatory, voluntary prayers, and just make istighfar. Ask, go to sujood. In sujood, ask Allah for forgiveness. Ask Allah for forgiveness. Ask Allah to show you the way. Ask Allah to help you against your own weaknesses, because that's what it's about. You know, there's a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was narrated. It was narrated by Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, one of the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who said Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he said, "Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam yaqulu ma min 'abdin yudnibu dhanban فَيُحْسِنُ الطُّهُورَ ثُمَّ يَقُومُ فَيُصَلِّي رَقْعَتَيْنِ. That there is not a servant who has committed a sin and he makes wudu and he prays raq'atayn, two raq'at prayer where he makes sujood twice, and ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ إِلَّا غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. And then he asks for the forgiveness of Allah. If a servant of Allah does this, then there is none that does this that will not get the forgiveness of Allah. Allah will forgive them. And this is so important, because that's all you got to do. You don't have to make, it's not complicated. You don't have to make it more complicated than it is. Like, simply stop what you're doing. Go make wudu. Pray two rak'ah and ask Allah for forgiveness. Ask Allah to help you. And then, like, raise the barriers between you and your sins. Meaning, like, put barriers between you and your sin. Whatever it is that you're weak in, like whatever your problem is, like put a barrier between you and that sin. Like, you know your weaknesses. If it's connection with someone that you shouldn't be connected to, like change your phone number. Like, sounds a little extreme, right? But what's more extreme? Is it more extreme that you stay away from salah because of the sins that you're committing, and in the end you end up in Jahannam? Is that better, or is it better that you just change your number? Or is it better that, you know, I'm giving you an example, but you can do absolutely anything. Put a barrier between you and your sin. If you do that, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see that you are actively working towards taking the right steps. And if you are actively taking the right steps and you're making istighfar, you're repenting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءُ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nuh, like, seek repent to Allah. If you repent to Allah, then Allah will bless you with an abundance. And the abundance comes in the form of wealth, in the form of children, all the things that you and I want. Relationships, jannat, you know, like paradise in the dunya before you get to the akhirah. Like, Allah will give it to you. But the thing is, like, you have to take the steps. Like, stop what you're doing, make tawbah, ask Allah for forgiveness. Like, be hopeful that Allah will forgive you. Don't make tawbah and think, oh, Allah will never forgive me. My sins are too big. Your sins cannot be too big for the mercy of Allah. The mercy of Allah is so big, so unlimited, that it can encompass anything. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in that verse that if you turn to Allah, then Allah will forgive you. Allah loves to forgive, and His mercy will encompass all sins. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'an. Allah forgives all sins. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to leave you with that. Jazakumullah khair. If you have any questions, by all means, leave a message. And inshallah ta'ala, I will see you in the next episode. So jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum.